guys, welcome to CNA Films and Animation.
What we did today was, because Alan is going to be gone for several months.
Yep.
I figured we'd let him choose what we review today.
Yep. And I chose one that we had both wanted to see. I was kind of hoping this film would be campy and kind of a maybe bizarre, neat film.
Mm-hmm.
And I chose the 2012 film Iron Sky.
So, what was Iron Sky about, Alan?
Well, after, towards the end of World War II, the Nazis, having been beaten back and losing, fled to the dark side of the moon to set up a fortress to rebuild to eventually come back.
Mm-hmm.
And that fortress is found by two astronauts who are on a mission for the president to bring up, to gain favor for the president who is trying to get reelected in an upcoming election. And turns out we on Earth have gone much further with technology than the Nazis on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
So the Nazis decide to come early to try to get some of that new technology to help fuel their war machines.
Mm-hmm.
So they can later invade the Earth.
I guess I'll start. I found this film to be interesting. It didn't really grab my interest.
Mm-hmm.
I appreciate a lot of the ideas that went on in this film. There were some neat special effects. There were some well executed ideas, but as a movie as a whole, I don't think it worked all that well. It's about an hour and a half long, and honestly, it's about an hour and 15 minutes too long. I think this would have been a better short film than it would have been a full-length feature. But, it's not a bad film, but it's not one that I would say you have to rush out and go see.
Yeah, this film's really, I guess, the main part is, it's going on the views of, well, not views, it's kind of satiring the views of governments,
mm-hmm.
especially the U.S. and the Nazi governments.
Mm-hmm.
For the Nazis, it shows how a nation can be led to believe one thing, led to have values and beliefs that are not accepted,
mm-hmm.
especially today. And I thought they did a good job of that. They have a Sarah Palin look-alike as the President of the United States, and unfortunately I can see I don't know if her, they never followed her, but I can see a president acting the way she was.
Mm-hmm.
They were really
satirizing.
Yeah, satirizing her, which, and the government lying but expecting everybody to follow what it says. Governments all fighting amongst each other for who's right, who's wrong. It kind of is building up to this whole Nazi invasion, and it's put down rather easily.
Mm-hmm.
And what I didn't quite understand was the Nazis, they're ahead of us and behind us at the same time.
Yeah.
They have UFOs, and they're able to live on the moon, which we can't do.
Mm-hmm.
But their technology is almost, I guess, diesel punk.
Yeah.
And it's very, it's, the visuals are very neat. The designs are very cool. It's just, it's lacking, you see a lot of the views from both sides. It is neat. This was my cup of tea. I thought it was going to be a little bit more campier, a little bit more invasion-y.
A little more fun, yeah.
Yeah, this was more of a serious trying to be film.
Yeah.
Apparently everybody in 2018 had forgotten about the Nazis. That irritated me. The Sarah Palin look-alike pretty much adopts Nazism to, well, not Nazis, the, what Nazism is portrayed to be, the good part of Nazism.
Yeah.
Which sugarcoats all the horrible things they do, but that's beside the point. She uses it to pretty much try to get reelected, and her approval rating skyrockets. The whole, there's this whole part where this girl who's supposed to be pure for the Nazis, she learns pretty much everything that she knows is a lie very quickly, and immediately changes her views. I rather doubt, because as hard as they were embedded into her from birth, she accepts that they're wrong really fast.
Yeah.
They do several things, and it's like, why did they do this? And really? But I can see it. They're going for more realistic to a point. To a point. Like, how Nazis were and how they would be. And this film wasn't what I thought it was, would be going in. It had some interesting points to it. I will give it that. If you want to see a film that satirizes a lot of stuff, I recommend it. Otherwise, not really.
Yeah.
It's not fun, not really a fun movie. It's not a campy movie. There's not much humor into it.
Yeah. So, what would you give it out of 10?
I'd probably give it a 5, because for what it does, it's spot on, but it's just not a very entertaining film.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll probably go about 4.5. You know, this was a little too boring. Took itself way too seriously. Some really good ideas, but just was not executed very well.
Yeah.
But, yeah. So, anything you want to say to the audience before you take off?
Well, guys, it's been great. Thank you for watching our videos. Be sure to keep following Cory here.
Yeah.
I'll see you guys for our 200th video.
And also, we'll have a top 5 list here in next month or so. So.
Yep, be sure to check in for both of those.
Yep, and when will we see you again, Alan?
I'll be back in August.
Alright, cool.
Alright.
Well, you know, guys, I just want to say thanks for watching. Thanks for, you know, supporting us. And, you know, be sure to, if you like this video, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe.
Be sure to check out our other videos.
Be sure to follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And as always, I'm Cory.
I'm Alan.
And I will see you guys pretty much every day this summer. He'll see you guys again in August. See you later.
Bye.